He became the boy's best friend. He lent him some books to read. The first books the kid had ever read about anything. For the first time, he saw a world that was bigger than the one he'd been born into. And he wanted more. He wanted to be something more.
A writer.
Yeah, but he had no idea what the word really meant. Certainly didn't have a clue about how to go about it.
You grew up in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm.
Grew up in Philly, but born in London, actually.
London?
Vous allez commander quelque chose, parce que sinon je vais devoir libérer la table. Oh, les Américains.
What did she just say?
What did she say? Well, my French was a little weak, but I'm pretty sure she said she loves you. Go talk to her.
No.
Go.
Oh, honey.
Go talk to her.
Come on, if you don't, I will.
He found out sometime later that what she'd actually said was pay your check and get the hell out of here. But who was he to question fate? He'd picked up one word of French.
Oui.
And she knew one word of English.
Yes.
It was the perfect relationship.
Je veux toujours manger le... What is ice
manger.
Cream?
Manger.
Je veux toujours manger la ice cream.
Le glace.
Le glace?
Oh.
What? What?
It's cold in my head.
Cold in your head?
Yeah, pain.
Here, go like this. Take your finger, like this. Under your tongue. It's a little trick and make it go away, okay?
It doesn't want to go.
Give it a second, okay? No?
It's gone.
Told you.
Okay, one more.
What happened?
He got discharged from the army. Once was his whole world suddenly seemed small. Nothing had changed since he'd been away, except him. He had changed. For the first time in his life, he tried to write. He tried to write about Paris, about what he'd seen and how he'd felt, but the words just wouldn't come. He knew the life he wanted. He knew what he had to do to get it. Began his apprenticeship as a writer. got a job as a journalist for a small English language weekly. There were a lot of them springing up for all the expats, and they'd hire anyone who could string a few words together. It was a good place to learn. Married Celia 2 weeks later. £6 3 ounces. Eyes like a mother. That was his moment. Not that he knew it at the time. Maybe one never does. She used to cry so much. At times you could barely think, let alone write.
Sir?
She was sick.
The wife?
My daughter. Nothing he could do. Celia was never the same. And he wasn't the same either. Even though he tried to pretend.
Faut que tu manges. Chérie, mange. I'll be back later.
Celia.
She said she'd gone home to her mother's in the country. Needed time to think. She needed to be apart. Couldn't remember sleeping or eating. The words simply poured out of him. A stream that he could not control nor question where they came from. The words became form, the form became whole, and after 2 weeks, it was finished.
And then?
Daddy slept. Dreamless sleep. When he woke, he cleaned the apartment and went to find his wife. She looked like a child to him, sitting in the room she grew up in. She begged him to go back to Paris without her.
Thank you.
weeks later, she finally came home. So grateful to have a home.
Thank you.
For you.
Just wanted to hold her.
So happy you're back.
See her laugh again.
So you read my story?
No, I'm not ready yet.
She said she wanted to start life over.
That's okay.
Said it like it would be the easiest thing in the world to do.
It's in the valise. I don't understand. I had it with me on the train.
What?
I had it with me on the train.
But it was in a different case? Ils sont où? Je les vois pas. Il les a pas laissés chez ta mère?
It shouldn't have meant anything, but
no?
Writing that story, it somehow
saved it. Time.
How could she not understand?
Je pense que j'ai fait exprès de les perdre.
For years, he'd never forgive himself for caring about those stupid words.
You know what? You are not the only one who lost her.
Tried to patch things up together. But you can't erase the past. No matter how much you want to. And for the first time, the young man began to long for home. And soon, longing grew so strong, he left. Never went back to Paris. Never saw Celia again. But after he lost those pages, he was never able to set down one word that looked right to him. Maybe he was afraid of going that deep again. Perhaps he just lost the knack. Anyway, he stopped trying. And after a time, he found a little town up north, settled there, found a kind of peace.
How's that feel?
But wait, it's not over yet. This is where